Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part three of basic percent problems, and we do these videos. The first one is a review of what we did in parts one and two, and then we go over these new types of problems, these second two problems. We're going to go on to a different kind of percent problem, but first, let's look at this problem we did on part one. Find 75% of 44. Now, another way this could have been asked is, what is 75% of 44? So it could have been asked as a question. Now, the way we did this is if we know the percent, and it says of the number, what we need to do is multiply. We take that percent, right, as a decimal or as a fraction, and then we times it by the number, and that would give us our answer. So in this example, one of the ways we did it is we changed 75% to a fraction. So that was 3/4 of, means times, in this case, 44. So 75% of 44 is the same thing as 3/4 times 44. And then we canceled, and we got the answer of 33. That's the number we're looking for. Now, another way to do this is think in terms of equations. When it says, what is 75% of 44? What is the thing we're looking for? So we could let that be some variable. I'm just going to call it A. We're looking for something. And is translates to equals. So we say what, which is A, is, change that to equals, 75%, change that to the fraction 3/4 of times 44. And then we have this equation, A equals 33. But in the end, it doesn't ask, what's A? It's just asking for the number. So remember, if we write it like this, A is just what you did so that you don't have to write out in words, the number I'm looking for is, etc. Okay, we're going to take this same problem and write it a little bit differently where we know something else. Like for instance, we now know that 33 is 75% of 44. So let's say the question was this. 33 is 75% of what? Well, we know the answer is going to be 44 because if you look at what we had up here, the what we're looking for is 33. So it's sort of like taking this equation and I'm changing what I know. I'm going to put the 33 in here and I don't know the 44. So our answer should be 44. Okay, so hopefully we could agree that that's what we'll be looking for. But how are we going to do this problem? Well, we're going to write this as an equation. The thing we're looking for, we're going to put a variable in for it. So this, what, will be our variable. And in the end, we don't want to say n equals or x equals. We're just going to say what the answer is to the problem. So we start out with just replacing everything we see here into a little translation into an algebraic equation. We've got the number 33 is, means equals. 75%. Now, we can either write that as 3/4 or we could write it as 0.75. I'm going to do it both ways. I'm going to start off with 3/4. And it says, of what? Of, we're going to multiply. And what? That's what we don't know. So this time I'm going to use a B. I'll use a different letter than I did in this one. So 33 equals 3/4 of B. And then the question is, how would I solve that equation? Well, there's a couple ways you could solve that equation. One is you can multiply both sides by the reciprocal 4/3. And that's the way I'm going to do it. First, I'm going to move this over just a little bit, everything. Sorry. So I have a little space. And I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 4/3. Now, why is that? Because 3/4 times b, we want to know what 1 times b equals. So if I do the reciprocal, multiply by the reciprocal, the 4s will cancel, the 3s will cancel, I'll have 1b. But whatever you multiply on one side of the equation, you need to multiply on the other side of the equation. So we're ready to go here. What cancels? Well, the 4 going to cancel with that 4, the 3 with that 3. So on the right hand side, I'm just going to have 1b, which will be b, which is what I'm looking for. And now on the other side of the equation, let's see, 3 goes into 33 11 times. So I'll have 4 times 11, 44 over 1, which is 44. And of course, we knew the answer was going to be 44. So we don't want to write our answer as 44. We just want to write the number is 44, or just put a box around 44. That would be the answer. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to do some problems like this where we know this amount that it says 75% or whatever the percent of, and we're not going to know what goes after the word of. So that's going to be what we're looking for in these problems. Before doing a new problem, let's do the same problem again, but we'll do it by changing the percent to a decimal, because it doesn't matter if you write it as a decimal or a fraction. You just have to change it from percent form. So again, 33 is means equals. 0.75 is what I'll use for 75% this time. So I'm going to rewrite 75% as 0.75 times what? Now, instead of putting a time sign, I'm just going to put b. Okay, that'll be my variable. You could put X or N or W, whatever you'd like. But I don't want that times sign to be confused with this decimal point. All right, so how would you solve for B? Well, if you have a calculator, or even if you don't have a calculator, you could just divide both sides by 0.75 to get the answer. So either you have to do it the long way, do 0.75 into 33, or you could just get your calculator out, and 33 divided by 0.75 is 44. So you end up with the same answer of 44. Now, if you're not allowed to use a calculator, it's really easier to write it as a fraction and multiply by the reciprocal. So just take a quick look up here. When I wrote it as 3/4, see how nicely it all worked out? I had 3/4 b. If I multiply by 4/3, the 3 canceled into the 33. So the arithmetic was pretty simple. If you don't have that, a calculator, and you want to use decimals, then I guess you're going to have to do long division with decimals. So you would have to do 0.75 into 33. And then remember, if you have a decimal here, you have to move it to the right too, and this to the right too. That's like multiplying the numerator and denominator of this fraction by 100, by the way. Think about that. If you multiply the numerator and denominator by 100, you'd have 3,300 over 75, which is exactly what I have here, 3,300 divided by 75. And then you'd have to do long division here. And, well, 75 doesn't go into 33, but into 330 it does go 4 times. So you'd have to do 4 times 75, which is 300. Then bring down the next 0. And then 75 into 300 goes 4. And so you would still get the right answer. You would still get 44. So those are two methods for doing that same problem. So here's another problem. 45 is 20% of what? Very similar. Try writing this as an equation and solving it on your own first. All right, let's go for it. So we've got 45. Well, just write the number 45. Is... okay, we could write equals 20%. Now, that's up to you if you want to write that as 0.2 or if you want to write that as a fraction. I'm really good with fractions, so I'm going to write it as a fraction. 20% means 20 hundredths, which reduces to 1/5. So you could write 20 hundredths, you could write 1/5, or you could write 0.2 times what, because it says of means times. And for what, I'm just going to put an X. Because remember, it doesn't matter what variable you use. But that is in the numerator. Think of that as x over 1. All right, how would I solve this? I want the x isolated, so you'd need to multiply both sides by the reciprocal of 1/5, which is 5. So if I multiply the right-hand side by 5 and the left-hand side by 5, I get 225 equals x. Remember, there was no x in the problem. It's just like somebody comes up to you and says, 45 is 20% of what? And you would say, oh, 225, that's my answer. Now, what if you wanted to do this with decimals? You'd write 45 equals, how do you write 20% as a decimal? It's 20 divided by 100, so you move the decimal 2 to the left, 0.2x, let's say. And then you would divide both sides by 0.2. Then you have to, of course, figure out what to do with this 45 divided by 0.2. That's not 45 divided by 2, it's by 45 divided by 0.2, which is dividing by 2/10. So there's a couple ways you could deal with this. You could just do your long division, or you can get out a calculator, or here's another way you might do it. If you don't like this decimal in the denominator, it's easier when there's no decimals. You could multiply the numerator and denominator both by 10. And if you do that, then you won't have a decimal in the denominator, right? You've got 10 times 45, that is 450. But what do you have in the denominator? 10 times 0.2 is the same thing as just 2. So you're going to get 225 again. Now, you get the same answer if you just do 45 divided by 0.2 in your calculator, or if you go over here and do a little long division, 0.2 into 45, move the decimal over 1, and if you divide 2 into 450, you're still going to get 225. So you have options. But no matter how you look at it, 45 is 20% of 225.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.